إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليما كثيرا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله Indeed, the most truthful of speech is the book of Allah. وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم And the best guidance is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها And the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent into this religion of ours. وَكُلَّ مُحْدَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٍ And everything we newly invent in this religion of ours is an innovation. وَكُلَّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٍ And every innovation is misguidance and it leads astray. وَكُلَّ ضَلَالَةٍ فِي النَّارِ And every going astray, every misguidance is in the hellfire. ثُمَّ أَمَّا بَعْدٍ My dear brothers in Islam, we find ourselves in this severe heat. We're in the upcoming week. We will see temperatures that they're saying will reach 107, 108, 109, 110, and the likes of this. And some may say, gosh, some may say, subhanallah, some may curse the heat, but we should know better than this. We should look at it for what it is, for the sign and the proof that it is. And Abi Huraira radiallahu anhu, he said that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, فَإِنَّ شِدَّةِ الْحَرْ مِنْ فَيْحِ جَهَنَّمْ That the intensity of the heat is from the raging of the fire of the hellfire. And the Prophet ﷺ, he added, وَاشْتَكَّتِ النَّارِ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهَا فَقَالَتْ يَا رَبِّ أَكَلَ بَعْضِي بَعْضًا And the Prophet ﷺ, he narrated that the hellfire of hell complained to its Lord, saying, Oh my Lord, parts of me, my parts are eating and destroying one another. So the Prophet ﷺ, he continued to narrate, فَأَذِنَ لَهَا بِنَفْسَيْنِ نَفْسٍ فِي الشِّتَاءِ وَنَفْسٍ فِي الصَّيْفِ فَهُوَ أَشَدُّ مَا تَجِدُونَ مِنَ الْحَرِّ وَأَشَدُّ مَا تَجِدُونَ مِنْ زَمْهَرِيرِ This hadith which is in Sahih al-Bukhari, the Prophet ﷺ then explained, knowing that the severity of this heat in this dunya is from the intensity of the raging of the hellfire. And he said, after saying that parts of it were destroying each other, Allah allowed it to take two breaths, one in the winter and one in the summer. And the breath in the summer is at the time when you feel the severest heat. So Allahu A'lam, this could be the breathing of the hellfire to release some of its heat. And the breath in the winter is at the time when you feel the severest cold. وعن أبي سعيد رضي الله عنه قال أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال ناركم هذه جزء من سبعين جزءا من نار جهنم لكل جزء منها حرها This hadith which is Hasan in the Sunnah of Tirmidhi The Prophet ﷺ said This fire of yours is one part of 70 parts of the fire of the hellfire Each part of it is like the heat of this one So we complain of this heat, the fire we see in this life, the heat we see in this life. And yet there are some 69 plus other parts, or potentially more, to the parts of the hellfire just like this type of heat and punishment. So the hellfire is real. It is already created, and it continues to rage. And it has been since Allah created it. So work in this dunya to save yourself from it by affirming your tawheed and ridding every drop of shirk from your life. Even if it means you oppose the culture that you were brought up upon. Live by the Quran and the Sunnah without opposition to it because of your whims or your desires and definitely not because of the times we're living in or the country that we live in. This is not an excuse for us to stray away from the path that Allah called us toward. Allah says, وَمَنْ لَمْ يُؤْمِنْ بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ فَإِنَّا أَعْتَدْنَا لِلْكَافِرِينَ سَعِيرًا Allah says what means, and whoever does not believe in Allah and His Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then verily we have prepared for the disbelievers a blazing fire. Wa an Adi ibn Hatim radiyallahu anhu, he said, "Sami'tu Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam yaqul, 'Attaqu an-nar walau bi shiqqi tamrah.'" The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, he was heard to have said, "Save yourself from the hellfire, from the raging of that heat." And this heat we're feeling is a reminder of the heat of the hellfire. "Save yourself from the hellfire even by giving half a date in charity." Rawahu al-Bukhari. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, "فَإِنْ لَمْ تَفْعَلُوا وَلَنْ تَفْعَلُوا فَاتَّقُوا النَّارَ الَّتِي وَقُودُهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةُ أُعِدَّتْ لِلْكَافِرِينَ." Allah said what means, "But if you do not, and surely you can never not, and you can never do it, then fear the fire of hell, whose fuel is men and stones prepared for the disbelievers." It doesn't need wood to rage. It doesn't need kerosene or gasoline to rage. It doesn't need charcoal to rage. Its fuel is mankind, men and stones, and that's what will give it the fuel and the rage. ثُمَّ قَالَ اللَّهُ وَقُلِ الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ فَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيُؤْمِنْ وَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيَكْفُرْ إِنَّا أَعْتَدْنَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ نَارًا أَحَاطُ بِهِمْ سُرَادِقُهَا وَإِنْ يَسْتَغِيثُوا يُغَاثُوا بِمَاءٍ كَالْمُهْنِ يَشْوِي الْوُجُوهَ بِئْسَ الشَّرَابُ وَسَاءَتْ مُرْتَفَقًا." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said what means, and say, "The truth is from your Lord. Then whoever wills, let him or her believe. And whoever wills, let him or her disbelieve. Verily we have prepared for the zalimun, those who are not just the mushrikeen, the polytheists, but also those who do wrong, a fire whose walls will be surrounding them. And if they ask for relief, if they ask for relief from that water and the likes, they will be granted a water like boiling oil that will scald their faces. Terrible is the drink, and an evil murtafiqa, an evil dwelling or resting place." So this heat that we experience should remind us that it is a part of the heat of the hellfire. And this heat that we experience in this dunya is the breath that Allah gave Jahannam, because parts of it were eating each other up. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرَ اللَّهِ لِي وَلَكُمْ أَدُعُ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبُكُمْ. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونصلي ونسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah says, "Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, ya ayyuhalladhina amanu qu anfusikum wa ahlikum nara waquduha an-nasu wal hijara 'alayha mala'ikatun ghiladun shidadun la ya'sun Allaha ma amarahum wa yaf'aluna ma yu'marun." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says what means, "O you who believe, ward off, save yourselves and your families from the fire of Jahannam, whose fuel is men and stones, over which are appointed angels, stern and severe, who disobey not from executing the commands they receive from Allah, but do what they are commanded. My brothers in Islam, the raging of the hellfire again is part of what is causing the heat that we are experiencing in these times. As we summarize, Ubadah, he narrates a hadith from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that we find in Sahih al-Bukhari, where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "Man shahida an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah wa anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh wa anna Isa abdullah wa rasuluh wa kalimatuhu alqaha ila Maryam wa ruhun minhu wal jannatu haqq wan naru haqq adkhalahu Allahu al-jannah 'ala ma kana min al-'amal." The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said in the authentic hadith, "If anyone testifies that there is none worthy of worship except for Allah alone without partners, and that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is his slave and his messenger, and that Jesus alayhi salam is Allah's slave and his messenger, and his word which he bestowed on Maryam, and a spirit created by him, and that paradise is true, and that the hellfire is true, Allah will admit him or her into paradise with the deeds which he had done, even if those deeds were few." In another narration, it adds, "Min abwab al-jannah al-thamaniya ayyuha sha'." Another narration adds, "From any of the eight gates of paradise as he or she likes to enter from." For believing and implementing and having istiqamah by doing action. It was narrated from Anas ibn Malik that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man sa'al al-jannah thalath marratin qalat al-jannah Allahumma adkhilhu al-jannah." Whoever asks to enter Jannah three times in the day, Allah, Jannah will make a dua, oh Allah, let this person enter Jannah. ومن استجار من النار ثلاث مرات قالت النار اللهم أجره من النار. And whoever asks Allah to be saved from the hellfire three times in the day, then Jahannam will make a dua. The Jahannam that's already raging and burning and it has existed since Allah created it, waiting for it to be filled by men and stones. That fire, Jahannam, will make a dua, oh Allah, save this person from the hellfire. So we make this dua, my brothers and sisters in Islam, and we remind ourselves again that the heat we're experiencing is a breath that Jahannam was given because parts of it were eating each other up. So Allah gave it two breaths, one in the summer, one in the winter. And this is the reason for the severe heat of the summer and the severe cold of the winter. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك أنت سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات اللهم ادخلنا الجنة اللهم ادخلنا الجنة اللهم ادخلنا الجنة الفردوس الأعلى يا رب العالمين اللهم أجرنا من النار اللهم أجرنا من النار اللهم أجرنا من النار يا أرحم الراحمين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله